All right, guys, if you remember from earlier, this room here had some good spotting right at the entry here, and you can see it's completely gone. Now, I haven't even CRB'd yet. It's just pre-spray. So when you're using the right chemistry, it makes all the difference. So my efforts are going to be minimal. So at the end of the day, it is always wise to spend a little bit extra and get good chemistry instead of using the cheaper stuff just to save some money. So you can always raise your prices to justify the difference in the costs, but when you're providing a premium service, obviously the consumer that is going to use your service is understanding that they are getting a premium service out of your business. So it's always wise to upgrade and not downgrade. Spend that little extra, figure out your costs, and do it right. So it's just like a restaurant. I'm sure some of you have had a favorite restaurant at one point or another that instead of raising their prices a little bit, they've actually downgraded their food quality. And that's the worst thing you can do, because that's the first thing people are going to notice, is the quality of food is not as good anymore. Then you're gonna lose customers over that. Whereas if you charge a little bit extra, provide the same awesome quality food and service, people are gonna be more understanding of that, because obviously history has shown that prices of stuff have gone up. Inflation happens, unfortunately, and we have to adjust in order to run the business and operate to make some money. So keep that in mind. If you find something cheaper, if it's not working as well, discard it and go back to where you were, or keep searching for better quality. If somebody can show me something safer and same cost as what I'm paying now for the chemistry I use, or even more effective and safer for the same cost, or maybe just a little bit more, I would make the switch. But the company I get all my stuff from is constantly creating and trying to improve. So it's hard to switch when they're doing that. So just my little tip for today. So if you're getting into the cleaning industry for carpets, of course, something you should really think about investing in, and even if you feel like it's quite a bit of of an investment to start out with if you can swing it. Here's why a swivel wand is key, because normally that's about as far as I'd be able to get, probably max with most other wands. But because it swivels, I can get all the way to the wall with this wand. I'm sure most of you that have been watching my videos get that. But for those that are new and that are getting into the cleaning industry, answer this question for me. Is the extra money worth your time to not have to move that piece of furniture if the client requests that you clean under it? And also, what is your back work to you? Because moving furniture around, picking things up, is going to be more stress on your spine. And I have in the past, where I used to work, where we had just a straight wand, which if when you're cleaning open areas, if you don't like the swivel, then this little piece right here locks it in place. So there's really no excuse to not liking it. So just something to consider. Spend the extra money and get yourself a premium carpet wand that has the swivel feature on it. Your back will thank you, because there's no need for you to throw your back out, because I did it my old job, because we had cheap wands that were just the single jet titanium cheapies. I don't even know if they were titanium. It's been a lot of years, but save a little bit extra. Get yourself a premium wand. Most definitely one of the best choices I made was finding these wands and upping my game. Another situation. Would you be able to do that with a straight head wand? No. Not while keeping your wand vacuum pretty much 100% to the floor. So you're going to lose suction when you have to do this. Because you see, the higher you get up, the more you can hear the loss of suction. So I can get around corners, doors, all those things a lot faster and more efficiently than you can with a straight head wand. So keep that in mind when you're investing in your company. Or for the time being, get a mid-range and then upgrade as soon as you can. Goes without saying of just about everything. If you can get better equipment off the bat, you can expect faster, more efficient results. But if you can't at the time, just take a little longer to do your cleaning and dry passes to make up for it. Because not every machine and not every tool is made the same. Sure, that's probably pretty obvious, but you know, if I had weaker machines, I definitely would be moving even slower. That way I make sure I do a thorough, nice, even clean path with what I've got. And when you start upgrading to bigger machines, higher suction, more CFMs and lift. CFMs is what sends it back through the hose, and the lift is what pulls it out of the carpet. So I can take in more volume at a time. Means faster drying carpets. I can clean faster too. So I know I kind of went off a little bit from the wand, but kind of ties into everything. Better tools, better chemistry, like I mentioned earlier. Better results. Almost makes me think of a pizza commercial, Papa John's, except apply it to this. Better chemicals, better tools, Black Diamond Services. But on seriousness, guys, if you're in the cleaning industry, you'll understand once you get those tools how amazing it is to have them. But be warned, once you buy the better stuff and you're trying to grow your business, you can't go back. There's nothing wrong with that, because of course we want to always make our business the best it can be. Video I'll be able to do, guys. My phone battery is getting low, so this may be the only room I'll be able to do, so I gotta leave enough battery in case someone needs to get a hold of me. And I'm at about 15% right now. Videoing takes quite a bit since I've constantly got the screen on. Thank you all for sticking around during my little break from my family. All your comments that I've seen so far are welcoming back as far as videos coming out. I really appreciate it. Alright guys, so this is going to be it for this video. Thank you so much for watching. For those who watched my last video, notice it's already hit over 2,000 views in, what, a day and a half, maybe 2 days now since I posted it. That's amazing. But I was looking at some of the analytics of the video. 86% of you found that video through the browse feature. If you're watching this now, hit that sub button so you get the alerts. But it's awesome that it's being shown to that many new people, which all of you that are subscribed and watching the videos, that tells me you're hitting the like button, you're commenting on the videos. That's what YouTube likes to see, so it keeps recommending it to others. Plus, we also hit a small milestone and creeped over 1,500 subscribers. Thank you so much for that. I will do my best to keep uploading videos and keep you guys entertained and hopefully educated a little bit here. But remember, that's what the intention of this channel is a combination of course, ASMR, because everybody loves cleaning and it's satisfying, but it is also meant for documenting the growth of the business and a little bit of education, because there's times when I'm learning something too, find a new situation, and it helps me grow as a business person and as a cleaner. So thanks again, guys, for watching. Until next time, I will see you all later.